Hello everyone, nice to meet you. I'm Kyu-san, an illustrator and comic artist, and today I'll show you some simple tips and tricks to draw your character art in an easy and fast watercolor style with Clip Studio Paint. Let's start! Open your work in Clip Studio Paint. My idea for today is a character with summer vibes. It's the perfect example to show the basic watercolor style technique. Once the line art is finished, let's start coloring. Create a layer under the line art. Go to the tool, G-Pen, and add some colors like yellow for the hair, blue for the outfit, pink for the skin, and light blue and pink colors for the background. Don't worry about accuracy, as the colorize options will blend these colors. Select the line art layer and click the Set as Reference Layer button. This step is really important. The line art layer needs to be a reference layer for the colorization function to work. If the line art is in the background, the newly created color layer will be made above the lines, so it's good to have the line in the foreground. Then, select again the colors layer and go to Menu, Edit, Colorize Technology Preview, and select Use Hint Image and Colorize. Wait a few seconds and there it is! The program has created a new color layer with the blend mode set to in multiply and has blended all of the colors. Now grab the new color layer and put it under the line art layer. Then hidden it for now, clicking on the eye next to the layer. Create a new layer under the color layer. Go into Tool, Brush, Watercolor, and choose your favorite brush. The tools here are come with Clip Studio Paint. Personally, I chose the Running Color Edge Watercolor brush because I love the irregular shape similar to a traditional tool. With monochromatic colors, in my case, blue and violet, start to paint shadows on your work. If you want to blend while keeping the irregular shapes, go into Tool, Brush, Watercolor, and use the Wet Bleed Blender brush. This is the result. Activate the color layer which we previously hid and see the differences. If the colors are too strong, change the layer opacity as you prefer. Create a new layer with the Running Color Edge Watercolor brush and the white color, add some lights around the character. We have a good base now, let's complete it with defined lights and details. First, add some layers to add color effect. Create a new layer, go into the tool, Fill, refer only to editing layer and color it with an orange tone. Then, change the layer setting to soft light. Repeat the same step, changing the layer setting in saturation with custom opacity. I changed it to 40%. The colors are now more softer and brighter. Create a new layer, setting the blending mode to multiply. Go to the tool, Brush, Watercolor, and select the Running Color Edge Watercolor brush again. Add additional shadow splatters to the wall work. By doing this, I emphasized the color texture in the drawing. If the splatters are too dark, remember to change the layer opacity. To give the brush stroke a more traditional effect, go to the Tool Property, Subtool Detail Palette, Watercolor Edge, and add an edge to your brush. Combined with the layer option, you can create a nice light shadow border effect. Add a new layer with the blend mode set to overlay and put some light splatters around the character. In the background there is the sun. Considering this, I added some lights around the shapes to give more depth. Then, create new layer corrections with the blend mode set to Normal, Overlay, Soft Lights, and Glow Dodge. With G-Pen, Running Color Edge Watercolor and Standard Brushes, add all details like strokes, contrast colors, shadows, likes, and everything you need to refine your work. There it is! Now that illustration is completed, let's try to change the color palette to obtain different atmospheres. For example, the drawing here shows a morning atmosphere. Try to have an afternoon sunset atmosphere. First, create a new folder and drop in all active layers. Then, right-click and duplicate the folder. Right-click again and select Convert Layer Edge. Now have the work in a unique layer, but still have all the files if necessary. Duplicate this layer again to create a backup copy. Now create a new folder and drop the drawing into it. Go to Tool, Gradient, Sunset Gradient. Then create a new layer without changing the setting and add the gradient. Change the blending mode from normal to color burn. The colors are more darker and stronger, so change the opacity to blend the gradient better with the work underneath. Done! The color seems amazing. Let's try to do the same with a night atmosphere. Duplicate the backup drawing and drop it in another folder. First, darken all colors using two color layer corrections. Create a new layer with the blending mode set to overlay and with 100% opacity. Go to Fill, refer only to editing layer and fill the layer with a dark blue tone. Blue colors in the drawing are more saturated. Again, create a new layer with the blending mode set to overlay. Go to Fill, refer only to editing layer and fill the layer with a black color. Then, change the layer opacity as you prefer to make the atmosphere darker or lighter. I change the opacity to 50%. Then, go to the tool, Gradient, Foreground to Transparent. With a lighter color similar to Yellow Moon, add a light gradient from the top to the bottom. As you can see, the second color is transparent, so it shows a darker blue in the work. Finally, create a new layer with the blend mode set to darken. These options allow you to color only lighter parts and in yours darker ones. Go to Tool, Brush, Watercolor, Running Color Edge Watercolor, and add a bit of blue color in the sky. Then, create a new layer in normal setting. Go to the airbrush, droplet, and put white sparkles in the background to recall the starry sky. Finished! We have now three different layers that give different atmospheres without recoloring the drawing. This watercolor technique can emphasize the emotions and the atmosphere, giving a personal touch to the work. Which atmosphere do you prefer? Let me know in the comment. I hope the tutorial was helpful to you to make simple watercolor coloration with a few steps. I wish you everyone an amazing watercolor work with Clip Studio Paint, and see you in the next tutorial. Bye!